I published this circuit yesterday about the VHF oscillator that seemed to be working with the gate and the drain shortcut. But the problem is solved, and it is in fact easy. The laws of physics are not defied by this circuit. The key issue is here, between the gate and the drain. I have had soldered a piece of wire, and that piece of wire of approximately, say, 10 centimeters or so, formed a coil. And that's my new conclusion. It is simple, in fact. And I want to thank everyone thinking with me about this circuit and about this issue. This is the circuit between the gate and the drain. We have a piece of wire, and that in this case a white piece of wire, and that was a coil. Inside a MOSFET there is, as far as I know, a lot of capacitance. So between the gate and the source. So I think that also plays a role inside that MOSFET. And here the resistor, I changed the wire wound resistor that was here to, say, normal carbon film resistors. And as far as I know from my radio association, normal carbon film resistors start to have inductance on a frequency of approximately 300 megahertz. So that could not be the reason for oscillation. And another issue is here, I had tried to prevent long wirings. So I used this battery box, positive here, negative here, and at the moment we are on 8 volts. So the circuit works on 8 volts. Frequency is visible, and the frequency is now 8.9 megahertz. But when you take the length of the wire between the gate and the drain somewhat longer or smaller, you get to other frequencies. And here you see the table with 8 centimeters, a wire of 8 centimeters between the gate and the drain, it did not want to oscillate. But with 17 centimeters and 14 and 10 centimeters, we had we were in this frequency band between, say, 8 and 11 megahertz. So problem solved. Was a little bit disappointing because I also had, as the first idea, there was a kind of tunneling effect inside that MOSFET. Just like a beamer supposed. That was also my idea, but it is after all a classical radio oscillator, but with good properties. I had not expected that, and I can show the difference in frequency. I have here a ferrite rod, and when I stick it inside that piece of wire here, you see the difference in frequency. So that's the proof that that small piece of wire, say 10 centimeters, 18 centimeters, forms a tank circuit. Together with the capacitance, the natural capacitance inside the MOSFET. So, I'm interested when you want to do this experiment also, but now with a piece of wire, certain piece of wire with a certain length between the gate and the drain. Thanks for watching. Thanks for all your comments, thinking about this circuit. Wish you luck.